This country belongs to all of us. And the federal government, the presidency, must act fast because time is going. From north, west, northeast, north central, southwest, southeast, south, south, there is general insecurity. And this is being prepared by herdsmen. I want to repeat again, I have made it a petition to the presidency and to all security agencies before, that if they want peace, Meher Diala must be arrested. These are people who have owned up. They have taken responsibility that they have killed, they maimed, they raped, and do all sorts of atrocities. And yet their leadership is in Abuja, and nobody is confronting them. And until these people are arrested, when I talk, I was being castigated. I was being vilified. Nothing bad that was not said against me. I am this and that. But the reality is here. It is not just happening to Benue State today. It is happening to the entire country. Why is the federal government being silenced about this Fulani man? When will the federal government come out and criticize and arrest herdsmen carrying AK-47? When are they going to do that? Are we second citizens in this country? What gives Fulani man superior to any other person, to a tip man? I am not their slave. A Benue man is not a slave to any Fulani man in this country. And so federal government must do this. At a point in time, the federal government came out with a policy through the police that even those with license, den guns, double barrel, and pump action should surrender to police. How many times have the presidency come out to condemn that Fulani men are carrying AK-47 all over the place? This is not correct. We stand for justice, equity, and fairness. Whatever is happening to a Fulani man should also happen to any other person. That was why I called for the federal government to license me and many others to have guns, to have AK-47 too. Because if I have my AK-47, a Fulani man is coming there, he knows that I have, and he has, then we can fight each other. But you can't disarm me and arm a Fulani man. This is the point. So this is not right. The federal government is biased, it's unfair. The failure in security is caused by federal government. And maybe what I perceived is that the president is not aware of this. Because if he were aware, he would stop it. I know General Muhammadu Buhari retired as someone who is disciplined. But the people around him, sycophants and mediocres, are not willing to let him know the pains that Nigerians are going through. Mr. President, in case you're listening to me, I want you to know that your people, Nigerians, you promised Nigerians that you'll be fair to all. You said that you will be for everybody and for nobody. And now it will appear that you are just for Fulani people because nothing is coming from you to give the people confidence that you are their president. You are the president of Federal Republic of Nigeria. You are not the president of Fulani. You are the president of everybody. And I owe you a duty as a stakeholder in this nation to let you know that what is going on is wrong. And this has the potentials of dividing this country, which will not be in the interest of anyone. Some of us believe in the unity of this country. We believe in leadership, that every leader comes by God. But we have you the responsibility to advise you when things are going wrong. It is not everything that I know as governor, but I depend on leftenants. So you must depend on us, the whole country. Those who are silent are doing that as sycophants and mediocres. They're not willing to tell you the truth. The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth will set you free. Mr. President, if anybody is deceiving you, that all is well. It is not well with us here in Benue State. And what I can hear from other states, it is not well with Nigeria today. You must act fast before it is late.